everybody's music influences everybody else, but the one thread that's running through it is flat out blues. With Gate Mouth Brown and Robert Lockwood Jr., which is really coming out of pre-war blues all the way up to today. And then you go to someone like Scotty Moore, who made his fame collaborating with Elvis Presley. And then you get Ike Turner, who is just a big influence on rock, soul, and what have you. And it keeps going to another generation, Buddy Guy, Otis Rush, and Steve Cropper, and Matt Murphy, and then down another generation of Bonnie Raitt, Taj Mahal, then on down to another generation of Otis Grant and Lil Charlie. All these musicians, all of them aren't super famous, but the majority of them have been doing what they've been doing for a long time, and it's all been sort of a cross current of each other's styles, and I think that's what makes American music so great. It really makes the music special when it gets away from just one person in a corner by themselves doing whatever their thing, no matter how great it is. I mean, I would have loved to have heard Elvis Presley sing with Roy Orbison.
You look good, and you look good. You look good, and woman, you look good.
Well, I grew up, I always listened to Buddy Guy. And then after that, I got hit to Otis Rush. And when you have two players from that same era, that same time, that are so different, it's like a picture of their personality. Attracted me as well as I think thousands, maybe I don't know how many more guitar players, but it got was unexpected. You know, I mean, you don't know what's gonna happen. I always used to think, well, you don't know what happened because Buddy don't know what's gonna happen. It's great because he never plays the same way twice. It's always different and it's always fresh and it's always from the heart. Whereas with Otis, you know, Otis is the type of musician that is serious about how he sounds, you know, and he's serious about how he goes about being presented. So that, in other words, he's the type of guy that'll practice, and you can hear it. The way I try to write songs with somebody else in mind is I try to do something that's going to highlight their strong point. I figured on the slow minor blues that would highlight Otis Rush's strong point because he's such an emotional player. Someone like Gate Mouth Brown and Scotty Moore, I put a little jump blues and a little rockabilly and a little jazzy with the horns, try to mix it up so that they can play something they feel comfortable in. And working with Bonnie Raitt, something that she could play her style of slide.
Joe Lewis, anytime you live in, I'll be there.
We have one thing that's common thread running through us, that we both learned slide guitar from the Sickie Fair McDowell, though we both play totally different. Steve Cropper to me is the epitome of somebody that is secure. First thing he says to the musicians, look, we gotta have fun. We ain't having fun making this record, it's not gonna sound right.
I really thought it was great that Joe wanted to share, you know, that spotlight, you know, to have some friends come in and play with him.
When the band starts singing that down home blues, you just might wanna kick off your shoes. You can have a drink, but don't drink too much. We don't want you to get toe up on the floor. They'll be sitting in and having fun. The Mile High Club.
We had the studio booked for 3 hours to put Gate Mouth on, and he came in and his Wild Glory, and we sat there and we talked and we talked and we talked, and I got to being a producer and looking at my watch, and about 2.5 hours had gone by, and I knew we only had the studio for 3 hours, and finally I got up nerve enough to say, "Hey Gate, you think we ought to play a little guitar?" And he says, "Yeah, man, where is it?" One or two passes and boom, there we had it, and it's incredible.
Everybody played on this record like they were making a record of their own, and I really owe everybody a big debt of gratitude, because nobody slacked up on this. Everybody played their heart out, you know, and it was interesting to see how everybody went about it differently.